Hello, my friends. How are you doing? Today, we're going to have a look at Nick Collection, more specifically, the most powerful functions of Viveza, which is part of the Nick Collection. My name is Olivio. I'm a professional designer, and I want to thank all of my patrons who support me and make these videos possible. So, you probably have heard about Nick Collection. It's pretty famous. You can use it as a plugin inside of Affinity Photo. There's an old version of Nick Collection, which you can download for free. I will link it in the video description. And there is a new version, which you have to pay a little bit of money for that. But Nick Collection is so powerful, it's actually worth the money. I would say it's my favorite plugin collection ever, but you have to decide on your own. We just want to talk about Viveza today, and Viveza is about adjusting pictures, and the genius thing it is doing is that at the same time, it is very easy, playful, intuitive, you can just go with the flow. At the same time, it is super in-depth, very layered, kind of complex, but easy to understand. Don't worry about that. You just have to move around a little bit of levers. So let's go into that and look at what we want to do here. So here's one of my pictures that I've taken, and we want to improve that a little bit, because if you look at it, well, it's a nice night shot, but where is the love? Where is the passion? Where is the tasty colors and the beautiful light that makes you go, wow, what a picture? So we want to add this with Viveza, of course. So if you look on the right side, you will see, hey, that is a pretty slick interface. There's not much to look here because it's meant to be simple, and you have these sliders that you already know from other software tools. But if you look at the top, you have a really big button that says add control point. This means this plugin is mainly designed to work with control points. What are control points? What kind of problems do they solve? Well, the biggest problem in adjusting photos is you only want to address certain areas. You only want to address the shadow or the light or the water or the stone, or, well, you want to be specific with your editing, and these control points, well, they can do that for you. So you click on that, and then you click in your picture, and it creates this. So first of all, this is a duplicate of all the levers we can see over here on the right side, and I can adjust them right in the picture. And this is the first very powerful function, because I don't have to go looky here, looky there, looky here, looky there. No, I look at the colors I want to have, and I adjust them exactly where they are. So I don't want to have to go back and forward. I want to be in the flow when I'm doing the stuff. The next thing, the superpower, like this is mind-blowing actually, is when you hold the control key, and I'm sorry that I'm so excited, but I really love this function. When you hold the control key and you click and move this point here around, this is creating a mask for you. You can see this is like a mask preview, and you can see if I go to the lighter parts, it only selects the lighter part. So everything that's bright right now is selected. Now, if I go in the shadow areas, it only selects the shadow areas. How good is that? So this is basically content aware of what is going on in the picture. So if I put it here, and then this area here, like this lever down here, makes the circle around it a little bit bigger. So this is the area of effect. Now, again, if I press control and move this around, you can see now I have a little bit more area. Now you might say, well, this is not just the water. What are you talking about? This is also affecting the stone and stuff. But please keep in mind, if you have light coming from the water, if the water is glowing, of course, the glowing light is going onto the stone. So there's a connection between it. So you want to have a little bit of influence there too. That's pretty important. Okay, because you don't want to look at too digital. You want it to be like just right, just good. All right, so let's make this water tasty and nice. First of all, let's reduce the red, and then reduce the blue, and then bring out the green a little bit. Well, the green is already pretty powerful, I would say. I want this to be a little bit brighter. And also, let's see, we have here contrast. Let's give it a little bit more contrast. Then we have saturation. I think it's already pretty saturated. A structure sounds good. So let's give it a little bit more structure so we have more detail in the reflection. Shadow adjustment. Yes, let's put this down a little bit. The shadow adjustment and the warmth. Yeah, leave it like that. And you're now, you would say, well, what is going on? What are all these kind of things? The good thing is you don't really have to know. The only thing you have to know is, does it look good? Does it feel good? Is it the result I want to have? And this is what makes this so powerful. All the complexity you have from other software tools, you need to have like a photo degree, professor, doctorship of understanding curves and histograms and whatever. You don't need to know that here. You just move around these levers and you look at the result and say, well, I like it, you know? But if you really want to go into detail, we can look at the levers over here. So we have brightness, contrast, saturation, structure, shadow adjustment, warmth, red, green, blue, and of course the hue. So none of that is complex. None of that is something you would have to really ask yourself, what is that? Because everything is kind of self-explanatory. So that is super awesome. So as you can see here, if we look at the before and after, and over here we have a check mark next to the word preview, so I can have before and after. You can see with just one adjustment and playing around a little bit with levers, we turned a mucky, like, not that good looking water into like, wow, what the hell is going on here? Really good looking nightlight water effect. So that's already pretty amazing with just one adjustment. You don't have to have all these adjustments and layers and whatnot. Just this one thing. It's super easy. Okay, let's do some more because we want to have fun here, right? Okay, so let's do another. And here is the next powerful function. Before I forget, this is actually about not getting me super excited, but looking at powerful functions. So I want to create multiple of these points here. And now, if I click and drag, this creates a selection. This selection is not for the picture, it's for the points. So now you can see I have selected all three of these points. And, well, okay, maybe let's move them around a little bit so this makes a little bit more sense. So let's move one down here and one up there. And then I want to make this rather small, like so. And then I want to select all of them, like this. And now, on the right side, if you look there, you can see I can create a group. And if I create the group, only one of these adjustments is left over for me. And this means now if I pull this, you can see this will adjust all of these areas at the same time. So if you have an area that you want to affect and then have other areas you want to affect in the same way, you can do it with a group. And at the same time, you're very precise and you're very versatile. And of course, I can still click on this point and I can still move it around to another area. So then you're not fixed to each other just because they're in a group. All right, and let's select this and hit delete on my keyboard. And this, of course, then will delete, well, just this point, of course, that's good. But if I delete the main point, this will also delete the other point. So that was actually what I wanted to show you. Now let's have a practical example on how this would actually make sense. Well, look here at the right side of our fountain. Let's say I want to have just this part here darker. So I create a point here for adjustment, and then I make the area of adjustment really small, and then I can use control to give me a preview. Yeah, okay, that's the area. Now I hold my alt key, click and drag, and this will create a copy of that. So I can put this down here along the side. So this is only affecting this area. And now I can select all of those and then click group, boom, and there we go. And now if I make this darker, you can see that it will go along this side, just make this darker. And I can also say I want to have it a little bit less saturated, like so, just a tiny bit. That's pretty cool. Maybe make it a little bit cooler. So there we go. Actually, maybe make it a little bit warmer. Okay, that's pretty cool. So now we have done that, and that's already pretty awesome. Another thing I want to show you, and this is also kind of mind-blowing, is that you can separate out the darker areas and the lighter areas, like you've seen with the mask. But let me show you a case where this actually makes a lot of sense. So let's go here to the face, and you can see here now, we have, of course, lighter and darker areas, and we want to affect them differently. So let's make a control point here on the nose, or let's go here to the beard where we have this bright area. And then let's make this area of effect a little bit smaller, like so, and give me a little bit of a preview here. And you can see that this mainly affects the area in the face that are brighter, while the other areas in the shadow are darker. Good. So let's effect this a little bit. Let's make these areas kind of brighter and then also give it more structure. A lot more structure, actually. And then let's see, some more contrast. Nah, maybe not. Okay. Shadow adjustments, yeah, a little bit, like so. And then I want to have this actually a little bit cooler and also bring out the green a little bit and also bring out the blue a little bit, like so. Okay, that's pretty good. Now I want to make another control point here in this shadow area. Let's also make this a little bit smaller, like so. And you can now see that now only the shadow areas are bright while the lighter areas are actually darker. All right, so I can again use this to bring this a little bit down here. Again, give it some more structure, like so. And then let's see about the warmth of the face. Let's go like this. And then make it more blue. No, not that much blue. And then make it more green. And now, if we look at the before and after, you can see that a mucky face that didn't really give you much details or much to look at turned into something beautiful that has really outstanding details in it and really also nice colors, and you can really read the face now. You can really see the face now. You see how much of a difference it makes. And also a part of that, an interesting element of that, is now the face looks a lot sharper. So, and you can really fiddle around with that. You can really play around with that, go into the details even smaller. For example, you can say, hey, this decoration, these ornaments up here on the head, I want to have some more detail up here. So let's click on that, reduce it to just that area here. Let's go like this, and then just give this a lot more structure like this. Also a bit more contrast like so. And we can even pump up the brightness, play around with the shadows, maybe not like that, reduce them a little bit, see at the warmth, there we go, and also again a little bit of green, a little bit of blue, and there we go. And now suddenly up here we have a lot more detail in the head area. Well, actually this is a little bit, and it's a little bit more blue, I think. There we go, that looks pretty good. Okay. Before we go into, I drift off into too much detail here of playing around, you can see how powerful this is. The last two things I want to do is to make the stone here a little bit warmer. So let's click on that. Give me a quick preview of what's happening. That looks already good. So I want to make this a little bit warmer, give it a little bit more structure, and then let's play around a little bit with these values here. Like so is good. Let's see. Yes, reduce this a little bit. That's pretty okay. Shadow adjustment. Shadow a little bit darker. And then up here, also give this a nice green as we have in the lower part of our image. Actually, let's zoom out here a little bit so we have a bit more comparison. I don't want to make it that extreme, of course. I just want to make it a little bit similar to the area down there. So let's just play around with these areas here a little bit. Contrast, structure, maybe not. I almost forgot. One more thing I want to show you is down here in the background. This is nice, but I want the focus to be on that area. So I can click here on the window. Again, give me a little bit of preview. So this is actually inside of the window. And to make this less visible in the picture, I can just now reduce the brightness like so, and maybe also take a little bit away off the saturation. So now you won't focus, you won't look on that. And also in these parts here, you could say, well, this is still too bright down here. So let's go here, reduce the effect area, and then also make this a little bit darker. And so you can see now the background is getting darker, less attention on that. And now the before and after, it suddenly turned into a pretty interesting picture. You can still also go like this and see, whoa, that is a pretty big difference. And I mean, you can just play around for hours with this. It's just fun to do it. You stay in the flow. You can be really creative with that. And yeah, it's just a ton of fun to use this. So Have a look at it. You can download the old version, which is free. You can also download a demo version of the newer version to see what the difference is, what you like more. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to see more about the Nick collection, please let me know in the comments. Also, if you have specific questions, let me know down there. Maybe I turn it into a tutorial. Thank you very much for watching and see you in my next video. Bye.